all of the French speak. You know, these were all countries that at one time were colonial holdings of the French.
That's correct. That's correct. That was why Sékou Touré, mm-hmm. you know, had to quarrel with them. He refused to accept mm-hmm. that kind of, you know, when De Gaulle, you mm-hmm. know, said, okay, we'll give you independence, but this is what you mm-hmm. have to do. Only Sékou Touré said, no way. Mm-hmm. And the French got mad and even took all the electric poles in Guinea when they left, you mm-hmm. know, to punish them. Okay, so that's another obstacle when mm-hmm. you go into those countries to do business. The French has a way of stopping you mm-hmm. because A, they do not want, you know, those countries to threaten their financial interests, and mm-hmm. secondly, they do not want particular Anglophone mm-hmm. countries, you know, mm-hmm. like United States and Britain mm-hmm. to have influence in those countries mm-hmm. because of commercial distance.
And so that's an obstacle. When we say that Africa is open for business, we're saying in a real sense in almost every section of Africa, with the exception of those areas that are controlled by colonial France. Mm-hmm. Is that what we're saying?
That's correct.
You can't expect to go there and be successful.
That's correct.
If the French don't want you to be successful.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. absolutely. So that's important for people mm-hmm. to understand. Mm-hmm. You know, now you have the Chinese, mm-hmm. The Indians, mm-hmm. The Brazilians, mm-hmm. you know, having a whole lot of, you know, cuts in mm-hmm. the African business. Mm-hmm. You know, today, China is the third largest, you know, trading partner of Africa. The United States still number one, the European Union number two, mm-hmm. you know, China number three. And then you have Brazil coming in there, mm-hmm. you have India coming in there. Mm-hmm. And of course, in order to counterbalance, you know, what you call the European domination mm-hmm. of African business, you have what you call the BRIC countries today. That's mm-hmm. Brazil, you know, mm-hmm. Russia, mm-hmm. India, and China. Mm-hmm. BRIC, BRIC. Mm-hmm. These countries have formed a bloc of their own, mm-hmm. you know, to do business in Africa and other places mm-hmm. to counterbalance, you know, the mm-hmm. United States and European mm-hmm. you know, address, who've had a majority, mm-hmm. you know, interest in African business. And recently, you know, they invited South Africa, mm-hmm. you know, to become part of that, you know, group. For the mm-hmm. last meeting they had in Beijing, you know, sometime mm-hmm. last month, to the early part of this month, you know, mm-hmm. South Africa was invited. Mm-hmm. And amongst those four countries, mm-hmm. they're almost half of the world's population. Mm-hmm. And that's a very big market there.
Market,
you know, China is about 1.3, 1.5 billion people. Mm-hmm. India is about a billion people. Mm-hmm. Brazil is almost 300.
And all of those countries could be open for investment.
That's correct. Uh-huh. And those countries too are mm-hmm. open for investments. Mm-hmm. They are called the emerging markets. Mm-hmm. You know, most of these African economies are called mm-hmm. the frontier markets. Mm-hmm. That is countries that have, you know, the resources, mm-hmm. but lack the political and mm-hmm. economic stability. Mm-hmm. You know, they're frontier, you know, countries.
Countries. Mm-hmm.
So it's very important to understand that when you're going to Africa to do business, mm-hmm. you know, you have to look at, you know, these French-speaking countries, you know, the Lusophone countries, mm-hmm. that's the countries that were formerly, you know, a colony of Portugal, mm-hmm. that they're Lusophone countries, mm-hmm. Mozambique, you know, Cape Verde, Angola, you know, Guinea-Bissau, then of course the Anglophone.
And so in reality, over the last minute and a half we have here, mm-hmm. is that these colonial countries are still financially as powerful as they were during the colonial days, and independence really has not impacted them at all. the fact that these countries are independent, is that what we're saying?
Absolutely, absolutely. That's why they say that a lot of the African countries are independent on paper, uh-huh. you know, but in reality, mm-hmm. you know, most of them are not, because a lot of their economies mm-hmm. are still controlled by outside forces indirectly.
And of course, you would encourage, or at least you would advise, individuals who wish to be successful mm-hmm. not to deal with those countries that are still financially controlled by the former mother countries.
Well, that would be stretching it uh-huh. because I can say that 90% of the countries in Africa have a lot of their economies uh-huh. indirectly tied uh-huh. to former colonial powers.
But some more uh-huh. specifically than others.
That's correct. That some more, you know, uh-huh. Uh-huh. apart from South Africa or Nigeria, you know, most of the other countries really mm-hmm. still have a whole lot of dependence mm-hmm. on their former colonial.
And of course, Dr. Madu, let me thank you for that information. Let mm-hmm. me encourage our audience to tune in again next week for another informative edition of Comments. Thank you and good morning.